Hi, welcome to a tutorial from Equaser. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can calculate roots or solve the polynomial of second degree and third degree or quadratic and cubic equations using the scientific calculator Texas Instrument TI-36X Pro. So let's get started. The first equation that we have, let's say you have x squared minus 5x plus 6. This will be written in the form of x squared plus bx plus c equals 0. We will set this equal 0 and we find the value of x. So the value of a, b, and c are the coefficient of each term. Here, the last term, we have x to the power 0, x to the power 1, x to the power 2. So a is 1, b is minus 5, and then c is 6. Plus second function and poly. Here we have two options. For ax squared plus bx for polynomial, second degree, we press 1. Now a is 1, and then equal sign. And then for minus, press this minus, not this one, you will get error. So minus 5, and then equal sign, and then 6, equal sign. Now the cursor moves here for the last part that when you press it, you will see the value x is, x1 is 2 and then x2 is 3. This arrow shows that we can go back to x1 and x2. And also we have more values. If I press equal sign, I just go down. Here are some options that you can store the value of x1 and value of x2 in a memory, x, y, z, and t. And later on use it if you just need it. Just go to the right and press equal. So x1 is stored in x. And x2 is stored in y. I'm doing it, and then this is saving the equation for later, which I'm not going to use that. Equal sign. Now here we get also some values in regards to the vertex form of ax minus h squared plus k equals 0. So this a is in this case 1, h is 5 over 2. If you want to see the decimal value, just press this button. It's a value of h, and k is value of y at the minimum, so we can see that. And also if you have a look at the okay, let's do another example. This is now 3x squared plus 3x plus 2. So I'm just pressing it until c solve again. So now this is 3, and then we have 3, so I have to press clear, 3, and then 2. Now we have minus 1 over 2 if I want to show it as a fraction, as a decimal. So now this is the real part, and plus this is the imaginary part. As you can see here, I at the end. So it has real and imaginary, and x2 also the same thing. The only difference between the solution is the plus sign. If I scroll down and up, you will see the plus sign. So now let's do a polynomial of second degree, another one. So this time a is 1, b is minus 2, c is 1. Now this time it's just simple value. Now let's do the third degree. For that, I'm pressing clear. For third degree, press second function, polynomial, and then this time select 2. Now we have this equation is, we have to the power 3, and then we don't have to the power 2, so we have to put 0 to the power 2, that is for value of b, and then c, d, we don't have also d. So these are the values. A is minus 1, b is 0, we have to enter 0, you see I have to press clear, and then c is 4, and then d is 0. Once you enter, you get, now we will get three values, x1, x2 is 2, now x3 is 0. The same way we can get the other parameters. Now we have three values, x1, x2, x3, we can store an equation. So let me save x1 into x, x2 in the y, and x3 in z. Okay, so I'm quitting. Now let's just review the value that we have. To recall the values, here is the recall button with a second function, recall, and then you see all the values. So X is this value, you can press 1 to get it, and 2 and 3, the Z is 0. So if I want to get 1, just press 1, the value will be here, and I can do another calculation or work with this value, whatever you want to do. So now let's do another equation. So I'm pressing 2 this time for the third degree, press clear. My values are minus 1, B is 0, C is 3, and D is minus 5. Now this is my X1, this is my X2, and you see arrow shows here minus, so it means we have a imaginary part. So the answer is complex or imaginary, we have for X3 as well. This calculator cannot do polynomials of fourth degree. So this was the last example that I did. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video if you like it, and also subscribe if you're interested to get updates.